Welcome to Lean Six Sigma Green Belt Training, Measure Phase. Today we are going to start the second phase of the Lean Six Sigma project, Measure Phase. We already did Define Phase. Define Phase is about creating a picture of our process using words. So you describe the process, you describe the problem, people involved in your process and project. Now we are going to create the same picture but with the data. So define phase and measure phase is about current state, is about the current state of our process. So we are going to measure the current state data. The first document in measure phase is data collection plan. So it's about plan what we are going to measure, what we are going to collect. And the first question is why we need the data, why the data are important. One of the reasons is because we need to measure the process as is and measure the process to be after the improvement to prove that our project was successful. So based on the data, we are going to show that the success of our project. The second reason is to show the need for change. So with the data, you have a bigger comfort of saying that this process has to be changed. This is not working. So it's not only your feeling and opinion. It's about a specific data showing that we have a problem. Our customer is not happy. Our process takes too long. We are not competitive on the marketplace because of many defects in our process. So with the data, you feel more comfortable and you have a proof that something is not working correctly. Okay, so let's start with the first document. First document is data collection plan, as I mentioned before. And let's go to the first part of data collection plan. So look at your project charter and please look at your objective. Section. Look at what is your objective and what is the current state data needed to be collected. Is it about process? Are you going to collect data from the process? Or maybe you are going to collect data on the inputs level and maybe it's about outputs. So in the first column, please be very specific if your objective is related with the input, process, or output. You are still not sure how to do it, so think about the process of pizza preparation. The inputs is everything what you need to put on the table for the process to start. So if you want to create a pizza, the inputs is everything you need to put on the table. Then you have a process of pizza preparation, and the output is what you have for your customer, so the pizza. And look at your project charter and where are the problems and what's the objective? Is your objective to decrease number of defects in on inputs level? So for example, you are going to improve the quality of tomatoes, or is your objective related with the process? So something is not working correctly in the process and you are going to measure the data about the process itself, or maybe you are going to concentrate on the output and you are going to measure the output. So please be very specific what is the area of objective on the project charter. Okay, so let's assume that, for example, we have a problem with the process. So the inputs for pizza preparation are fine. The process is not working. And we are going to measure the time of pizza preparation because the problem is that it takes too long for the customer. And your metric, the second part of the data collection plan is going to be a time spent on pizza preparation, so time spent on the process. And you need to be very specific here. Are you going to measure the time spent on one pizza prepared, or are you going to measure the time spent on pizza preparation per day? So how many hours per day are spent on pizza preparation? So please be very specific what we are going to measure here as a metric. Or maybe you are going to measure only one specific process step. So then the first call will be P, process, and the second part will be time spent on specific process step. And the next column is about measure definition. So it's about more detailed information what they are going to measure. So for example, if the first metric is about P, process, and the first column is about P, process, the second is about metrics, so time spent per one pizza preparation. And the measure definition will be about how much time is spent to prepare one pizza in restaurant A in a specific time. So for example, in January. So please be very specific about the measure definition. It's very important that the measure definition is very specific. So you are very sure what kind of data you are looking for then. And in the same time, please check the project charter again. So everything is connected. So the objectives from the project charter are connected with the data collection plan. Okay, so now you know that you are going to measure the process. It will be measured in time, and the definition is about really very specific, what is the time spent per one pizza preparation in specific restaurant in specific time. Now you are going to look at the next column. It's about when. It's about what is the time you are going to take data from. So you need to be very specific that your data will be collected, for example, during January or February in specific year. The question is how much data we need, and the answer is it depends on your process, because if your process is daily, so for example you have a restaurant and on a daily basis you have a customer ordering a pizza, so for example you can take 1 month data. But if you have looking at the whole year, you can see that, for example, during the summer time, the number of orders is very low, because, for example, students are out for summer holidays. And then it's not good to take data for July or August or holiday time, basically, because it will not show the real process. So be careful with what time you choose to collect your data, and make sure you don't take the time when the process is the frequency of the process is very unusual. For example, you are selling the swimsuits, and the defects are related with the sales level. So you have a problem with the sales level. So you cannot take the data from the month where the sales level is very high or very low. So it's better, for example, to take the data from the whole year, so you have a comfort that the data presented will show the real situation of your process. In the same time, if you have a monthly process, for example, or even quarterly process, you cannot take data only for 1 month. You need to take data for 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. It depends on your process. If you are not sure what is the time frame of your data collection, please ask your team members. So what do you think? What is the time needed to have a data collection, so we have a real situation of the process show by data? I think it's very important as well to involve people who are going to collect the data with you to support you in this data collection plan preparation. So make sure that you discuss with them what should be measured together, looking at the project charter, and when to measure. Why? Because the last column of the data collection plan is who is going to measure the data. So it's better to involve people in the very beginning in this project preparation and in measure phase, so they will help you later to collect the data. So make sure that you have a data collection plan updated. You have a very specific objectives, what to measure, and your data collection plan is connected with the project charter. You know when to measure the data, and you know who will measure the data, who will collect the data. It may be a situation that you already have a data. For example, you will not start today to measure your data, but you have a historical data for last couple of months, couples of years even. So in this case, you don't need to measure the data again. You can take this historical data. So just put the time you have the data from here in this data collection plan. Okay, so now we have a data collection plan, and it's very important that you will include here all the data you are going to collect in your project. Sometimes it's a risk that you will collect too much data, so you will have too much data and it will be really not needed. Sometimes the risk of not having enough data. So please make sure you find a balance, that you have a comfort that it will not take you half of the year to collect the data, and in the same time you have enough data to start looking at them and analyzing them. Okay, so this part of the measure phase was about data collection plan, and please make sure that the data collection plan is related with the project objectives. This is very important, and it's about the current data, current state data. Okay, so now take your time, take an Excel spreadsheet, and please collect all the data. Later, on the next video, I will show you what to do with the data, how to present the data as a part of the measure phase. Okay, thank you very much.